daily in contact with the common Mwananchi.
Right.
So for Bomet, the verdict that was brought to yes was a reflection of exactly what's happening on the ground here.
And I want to bring this to Honorable Kositany. I hope you can still hear us. As I have you comment on this, the Deputy President is on record talking about the need to stop reggae. I want us to play that sound bite before we come to you, sir. Deputy President addressing members of the public and talking about BBI. Let's play that before we get to hear from Honorable Kositany, please.
Na mimi nataka niwaambie kanisa letu la Kenya na watu wote wanaomcha Mungu katika Kenya ya kwamba Kenya ni nchi ya Mungu na maombi. Kenya sio nchi ya reggae na bangi na waganga. Kenya ni nchi ya Mungu na maombi. Ninyi mnanielewa? Hiyo ndio Kenya, na Kenya itazidi kuwa ni nchi ambayo inamcha Mungu. Na msikue na wasiwasi. Hii reggae na bangi na waganga tutawakomesha Kenya hii. Hawawezi.
The Deputy President, the Honorable Kositany, I hope you managed to hear that, saying that he reggae, bangi, waganga, zote tutakomesha. In light of Super Tuesday and how far BBI has come, where does the Deputy President stand right now? Does this completely tear apart this narrative of stopping reggae for him?
Thank you, Sophia, and good evening, my fellow panelists, Murathe Kang'ata and Nick Salat. Sophia, I feel actually it surprises me when I see the Kieleweke team in a celebration mode about the passage of the BBI in the counties. You know, it is like somebody coming, challenging you to a contest and he has held a gun to your head. And then once you submit because you fear for your life, they go ahead and claim they had a very popular victory. The issue of passage of BBI through the county assemblies is actually a joke. It's actually a fallacy. It's actually an insult to the intelligence of Kenyans when you summon MCAs to intimidate them, like the Baringo MCAs were summoned and they were intimidated by Tuju. They were told that this is a party position. There is no party position, and as far as I'm concerned, in Jubilee. And Murathe there will bear me witness. He's the vice chair. I am the deputy SG. We have never held a meeting. There has never been a meeting where we have even been informed of its venue where it would take place. And me and the deputy president declined to attend. So there has never been a party position. But if they went on, and the Baringo MCs went on and rejected the BBI proposal. And then the next thing, they were summoned to EACC. And that was not actually just intimidate the Baringo MCS. That was a message to all other MCS that if you do this, this is what is coming. So MCS voted. They were intimidated. I said this earlier today that members of the county assembly deserve the car grant. Members of parliament, we get it. Members of the county assembly deserve the car grant. But this car grant is always given when MCAs are required to perform a certain constitutional duty. I remember they were promised this car grant some years ago. Then after that election, it never materialized. They were promised in 2017 so that they could campaign vigorously for the repeat election to campaign for President Uhuru Kenyatta. And then the car grant issue went silent. And even the way that the Salaries and Remuneration Commission ascended to the car grant issue is very suspect, because it shows you that the Salaries and Remuneration Commission is not independent. It is working at the whims of the executive. Let me come now to your question that of the clip that you just played of the deputy president saying we're going to stop reggae. Sophia, BBI has not passed. It has just passed through the county assemblies. There is still a process ahead. So I'm sure the deputy president in his prediction, we will ask him when, if that doesn't materialize, and when it materializes, he will be vindicated.
And yet he has not mounted a substantive no campaign. So this stopping reggae, but yet fence sitting, what is that about?
There is no fence sitting, Wainuna. We say that we are for a win-win situation. We actually said we wanted a consensus. We actually said we want a multiple choice referendum. And those are the things that we put in, because this whole BBI subject is a huge thing. And the key issues, the issue of 35% to counties does not require a referendum. The issue of the ward fund to be administered by the MCAs, ward development fund, does not require a referendum. What is being pushed here, or rather being escorted by all this, is the expansion of the executive, so that we can have the tribal kingpins rewarded the jobs. I saw them today parading themselves in a state house. That is not the Kenya we want. We want a Kenya whereby we will all feel that we've elected one person, has the president, and that is what the narrative that the Hustler Nation has brought, whereby right. William Ruto being the king, being the leader, we are not looking at William Ruto that he's from his tribe. We're looking at him as a leader who has an idea, who has the focus, and who has the willpower to change the lives of Kenyans.
Right. Let me bring it to Honorable Kang'ata first.
Well, it's important that I respond to de facto. Actually,